स्टार्ट।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। आई डॉक्टर निकहत नकवी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ द बॉटनी डिपार्टमेंट, सेंट फ्रांसिस डी सेल्स कॉलेज नागपुर, वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस स्टूडेंट्स वेबिनार ऑन फ्लोरल डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ सेमिनरी हिल्स नागपुर। दिस वेबिनार इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स एंड बाय द स्टूडेंट्स। सेंट फ्रांसिस डी सेल्स कॉलेज इज अ कैथोलिक Christian minority institution managed by the Catholic Archdiocese of Nagpur, and the president is the Archbishop of Nagpur. From the time of its inception in 1956 till date, the college has focused itself with providing holistic development to the students, fostering self-reliance and building self-esteem and confidence with truth and love, which is the motto of our college. We are proud of the fact and are blessed that our college is located amidst sylvan surroundings, the serene and tranquil atmosphere, far away from the hustle and bustle of the city life, make the ambience of the institution conducive for learning, especially for a subject like botany. I request our principal, Dr. K.T. Thomas, who has always motivated and encouraged the SFS family in all the endeavors, to give his inaugural address.
Thank you, Naki madam. Good afternoon. First of all, I congratulate the botany department students and the staff for organizing such a webinar on floral diversity. Floral diversity refers to the diversity of plants occurring in a specific region. It generally refers to the diversity of naturally occurring or native plants. The conservation of plants has generated the sense of urgency. Humans and most other animals are most totally dependent on plants, directly or indirectly. Plants are the source of energy through their ability to convert the sun's energy through photosynthesis. Worldwide, 10,000 of species of higher plants and several hundreds of lower plants are currently used by humans for wide diversity of purpose, as food, fuel, fiber, oil, herbs, spices, industrial crops, and fodder for domesticated animals. It is generally accepted today that conservation of all biodiversity should be our goal, especially through the preservation and sustainable use of natural habitats. This is an ideal that is unlikely to be achieved. There are convincing scientific, economic, and social reasons for giving priority to the conservation of major centers of plants diversity throughout the world. This will lead the conservation of many animals and microorganism diversity as well. As flowers are not just beautiful to look at, but they also share a vital role in our ecosystem. Flowers attract insects and birds, which serves as pollinators for the plant itself. Insects and birds also help to keep the surrounding ecosystem of flower, as well as maintain healthy by keeping away the predators and utilizing the plants and flowers for their own growth. All the plants produce flower at some point during the process of their growth. The flower itself produces seeds, which are then pollinated by either being transported by birds or insects, or being released into wind or dropped from the plant. Flowers help to keep the ecosystem growing and provide new plant life, as well as help to sustain local insects and birds. Flowers help our ecosystem flourish and facilitate the expansion of our environment. If flowers are cut down or destroyed before pollination can occur, that particular species has a high chance of dying off in that area. In addition, local wildlife will also vanish in that area since they would have no food. I would like also to mention that flowers play an important role in making the life of human being more cheerful and happy. People use flowers in several forms or several occasions. Charm of flowers brighten up the spirit of the people and improve their mood. The most important function that flowers have, however, is their power to convey profound human emotions and thoughts the way no other object can. We witness floral diversity in the Seminary Hills, Nagpur. This webinar will focus on floral diversity of Seminary Hills, Nagpur. The key features will be why it is important to study and conserve flora. As this webinar is for the students and by the students, I wish the webinar will be a great takeaway. I wish all the students a great success for the webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words of appreciation and highlighting the importance of conservation of biodiversity, in which students can play a very pivotal role. The unique thing about this webinar is that it is not by any subject expert, but it will be presented by our students, Ms. Sana Shad, who is now in final year, and Mr. Mushahid Khan, who has completed his graduation this year. This work has been done by the students as part of their field project work in second year. We in SFS believe in learning by doing, and also that teaching should not be confined to the four walls of the classroom. In 2002, SFS Botanical Club was established. It is of the students, for the students, and by the students. Here we carry out various activities besides academics and regular coursework, which help in developing interest in the subject, which is a major challenge for all the teachers these days, love for nature, create an awareness about sustainable living and environment conservation, self-confidence, overall personality development, and groom the students into responsible citizens who contribute to nation development, which is our vision and mission also. The work presented in webinar is compilation of work being carried by the second year students every year as part of the field project work since last many years. The photographs have been taken by students from their mobiles since they can't afford expensive cameras, and I acknowledge the help rendered by my taxonomist friends from time to time in this project work. In fact, this project work has been a great learning experience for me as well. In this slideshow, there are more than 100 common wild plants and trees. I'm sure many more will be added by my students in coming years. I appreciate the efforts and hard work put in by Mushahid and Sana in making this presentation. I hope this slideshow will greatly help the students and nature lovers to know the common plants in the area and appreciate the wild glory around us. Sana, you can now start with the presentation.
So, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sana Shard. I am a student of SFS College, and today, along with Mushahid Khan, I will be taking you on a virtual walk in the wild, and we will try and stun you with the flora of Seminary Hills. In SFS College, we are really blessed to study in such a serene environment, perfectly surrounded by nature. A diverse flora like this in front of us demands attention. So, as a part of our field project, we have studied different wild plants on our campus. We have tried to understand their distribution, and since we are no experts, since we are merely students, we have prepared a presentation about the flora of Seminary Hills with a much needed guidance from our teachers and various experts. Now, in the time of COVID-19, I think we can all agree that we must be engaged with nature as much as possible, be it our gardens, be it just a tree in front of our house. We've chosen the subject botany, and it has taken the environmental knowledge we gain to a completely another level. Let's start with the presentation. Let me just quickly take you through what Seminary Hills is about. It is basically a hilltop in Nagpur, visited by almost everyone, hikers, bird watchers, joggers, of course, because of its rich biodiversity. It has often been called the lungs of Nagpur, and anyone who goes there is provided with a calm and rejuvenating atmosphere. As students of botany, I think it kind of becomes our job to inform our juniors that botany is really an interesting subject, and that it is not just about sitting in a classroom and studying plants. It is much more practical than we think it is. So of the plants we covered, there was a total of 37 families, with Fabaceae family dominating it with 22 different genera. Of these, we found 66 herbs, 6 climbers, and 32 trees. We'll start with the herbs first. We have a very beautiful plant first, Clytoria ternacea. Now, this plant has been recently gaining popularity in the organic industry because its flower is used to obtain natural dyes, specifically blue dyes, which is used in textile industries. A plant with a beautiful white flower, Coccinea grandis. This is a climber, commonly called ivy gourd, and some people consume it vegetable. Then we have jungly pudina, or Anisoids. Now, jungly pudina can become an invasive species where it is not native. So any country where it has been naturalized has suffered a massive reduce in biodiversity. A plant with a beautifully shaped and yellow colored flower, Cyda cordata. This plant has a small height. It is basically a subshrub, of course, belonging to the Malvaceae family. It has a monoadelphous condition. Now, we must have heard about Indian nettle. This Acalypha indica is commonly called Indian nettle, and belonging to the Euphorbiaceae family, this has a cyathium inflorescence. If you see this in the center. Now, Anthus eniospermus, this is commonly called as Ratanpurus. This only flowers in the rainy season. You can only see its flower in the rainy season. Let me tell you, this is the second species of Acalypha we have found. And again, this has a cyathium inflorescence. In Euphorbia geniculata, again, cyathium inflorescence from the Euphorbiaceae family. Its inflorescence has a nectary, and if you see this plant anywhere, it is almost every time surrounded with butterflies. then nodweed or Cinerella nodiflora, very short plant belonging to the Asteraceae family and has the hidden capitulum inflorescence. Then Biophytum sensitivum. This is a very common weed everywhere. Then the Hidiotis corymbosa. It has very minute, beautiful flowers. And because of the appearance of the flower, it is commonly called diamond flower. It is commonly called diamond flower. And in Marathi, this is called as pith patta. Sorry, pith papda, I think. Yes, pith papda. Then this is called sonkadi in Marathi, Pentanema indicum. Again, with the hidden capitulum inflorescence from the Asteraceae family. Now, this has large, beautiful purple colored flowers, Asistacia gangetica. Now, the name itself means something. The genus name Asistacia means inconsistency. This is related to the fact that these flowers, if you see, are regular, but the members of Acanthaceae are usually not regular, and that's what gives it the name Asistacia, meaning inconsistent. Now, I think a plant whose leaves are more beautiful than its flowers, Desmodium triflorum. This, if you see, this is one whole leaf with three leaflets which look like a clover. And this plant has it is known to be found even in high altitudes like the Himalayas. Now, an extremely invasive species has been introduced, Parthenium hysteroferus. This is famously called as Congress grass and sometimes even carrot grass. Another parasitic plant, Striga angustifolia. This is commonly called witchweed, and this is extremely harmful to economically important economically important crops. Indonesia echioides. This is also called Ranchimani commonly, and this flowers only in two separate periods, March to June and October to December. Then we have what is called as leaf flower, Phyllanthus fraternus. This is because of its appearance of the leaves in a floral arrangement. It is called leaf flower. Then we have what is called in Marathi, Lahan Jaswand, Hibiscus lobatus. This again, belonging to the Malvaceae family, is monoadelphous in condition. Then we have Dipterocanthus. Almost everywhere in India, tribals use this to apply against snake bites, or as in a paste form or in a juice form of the whole plant actually. Then we have Gomphrena serrata. This plant shows antimicrobial activity as well as antibacterial activities. And according to research, this has recently shown properties against a parasite which causes cerebral malaria in humans. Then we have Cleome viscosa. This is commonly called Asian spider flower, and its seeds are used to extract oil. And if you see, this is actually one whole plant array, and the petals are arranged in a semicircle. We have Spermacos articularis. This plant is known to be anti-inflammatory in nature. Then Sesamum orientale. This is connected with Sesamum indicum, which is the sesame seeds. Many even cultivate it thinking that it is Sesamum indicum. Then Commelina bengalensis. This is commonly called Bengal day flower, or Kena in Marathi. Alternanthera pungens. This is commonly called paper thorn. These flowers are arranged in clusters in the form of spikes. If you touch this flower, those spikes will come onto your finger and you'll have to physically remove these, and they are very thorny in nature. Then we have amaranth of the Amaranthaceae family, Digerum uricata. This flowers only between August and September. Then Ruellia tuberosa. I think children might know more about this plant because the pods of this plant pop when introduced with a little bit of moisture, and they're just used for playing around. In Crotalaria, this plant is called rattle pod commonly because the seeds of this plant start rattling because they become loose when they become mature. So that's what gives it the name. And one more interesting thing about this is the genus name is derived, the genus name of Crotalaria and the genus name of rattle snakes are derived from the same meaning, that is to rattle. And we have Cassia tora. This plant is surprisingly used as a substitute coffee or substitute tea. Some claim it tastes like its seeds taste like coffee, and some say it tastes like tea. Now, Vigna of the Fabaceae family, again of the dominating family. If you see its leaves, this is actually one whole leaf again, and these are the three leaflets. Now, Alyssocarpus vaginalis. Now, the flowers of these plants look really beautiful when we see them physically. And this has the typical papilionaceous corolla because, of course, because it belongs to the subfamily Papilionoidae. And this is an invasive weed itself, but itself is susceptible, very easily susceptible to a particular category of nematodes. And we have Pteramnus labialis. Its leaves are trifoliate, if you see. And Abel moschus ficalnius. This flowers only in late summer and autumn season. And again, belonging to the Malvaceae family, this is monoadelphous in condition. Acaeranthus aspera. If you see this plant properly, the leaves of this particular plant are used in Ganesh Puja, and this plant is literally available in every tropical and subtropical region. Now, Corchorus aestuans. Now, this is very commonly called East Indian mallow, and again, this only flowers in one particular period, that is August to October. Now, I think this is bushmint. Bushmint. Hyptis suaviolens. This is, in Hindi, this is called Vilayati Tulsi for some reason. And also bushmint. And if you see the family Lamiaceae, it is itself the mint family. Now, Cyda rhombifolia. This is a summer annual. And again, we have a member of the Malvaceae family. And this is monoadelphous in condition. This is an extremely invasive weed, Ipomia triloba. This was actually deemed a noxious weed by the Agricultural Ministry, which means you really have to take care of its growth, otherwise it will eat up the crops. This is also called morning glory by some. Then Cassia apsis. This is basically used in every traditional medicine and widely used in Ayurveda. A very beautiful plant. It produces beautiful multicolored bunches of flowers, Lantana camara. But as beautiful as it looks, it is extremely invasive. And anywhere it has been introduced, there are reports that it has led to a reduction in the biodiversity, in the local biodiversity. It outcompetes the native species there. This is extremely harmful. Then Chirchitta, as we call it in Hindi, Biden's bitter nata. This is again of the Astrid family and has a head and capitulum inflorescence. Then we have Blepharis repens. This uses, there are no medicine as of now, only that they are given to sick animals sometimes, the seeds. We have Vernonia cinerea. This again, Asteraceae actually takes the second lead in the most number of genera in the list of families. This plant again has the hidden capitulum inflorescence of the Asteraceae family. Euphorbia hirta. This is commonly called as asthma plant or asthma weed even because of its anti-inflammatory properties. Now, Trichodesma inequal. If you see in this photo, this its leaves actually clasp the stem, and that is what it what gives it the name clasping leaf borage. In Rajasthan, it is called as Sial Kato. Now, Antigonon leptotus. This produces very beautiful pink colored flowers. And even though it is a weed, many people use it to decorate their fences. This is a climber, let me mention, of the six climbers we found. Commelina. Let me remind you that this is the second species of Commelina that we have come across. There are actually three species of Commelina that we found. This is the second one we have so far seen in the slides. Crossandra infundibuliformis. Now, we can't see it in the picture, but this produces very beautiful salmon-colored flowers. They are also called firecracker flowers because the flowers tend to pop in when exposed to moisture. And these are basically just, this is also called aboli in Marathi. And this is just, the flowers are just used by women to decorate their hairs. Tephrosia purpurea. This species itself is commonly called the common Tephrosia. Or I think, yeah, it's called also called Sharpunkha in Marathi. This produces extremely beautiful flowers. Evolvulus alcenoids. This is also this is commonly called dwarf morning glory. And in Hindi and Marathi both, this plant is called as Vishnu Kanta. I bet everyone is still excited to know more about eye every day. Please stay online with us now. Mushahid will now be taking over the presentation.
Next, Mimilia sanguinea. It is a herb belonging to family Asteraceae, and flower shows capitulum inflorescence. And this plant is commonly called as lilac tassel flower.
Mushahid, your screen is not shared. Please share your screen. Your screen is not shared. Yes, now it's okay, Mushahid. Now you continue. It's okay, Mushahid, now.
Now it is visible, ma'am? Okay. So, now we have Amaranthus spinosus of family Amaranthaceae. Apart from medicinal uses, it is also used as a vegetable. And it is commonly called as pigweed. Now we have another species of Commelina. This is the third one. And the flower of Commelina is example of clistogamy. Clistogamy means the flowers are closed, which usually favors self-pollination. So further we have Lonia procumbens of family Asteraceae. It is locally called as Pathari. And flower is very beautiful and having a capsulum inflorescence or hedge, as we call. Next, we have a very beautiful wild plant that is Borrachia repens, and it belongs to family Nyctaginaceae and commonly called as spiderling. It has a diffuse branching and a very small yellow purple flower, as we can see in the picture. Next, we have Urena lobata, that is belonging to family Malvaceae, and it is commonly called as Congo jute, and it is used in the fever of malaria and diarrhea as well. Another herb of family Malvaceae, that is Triumphetta rhomboidea, and it is commonly called as diamond burbark because of the shape of the leaf. As we can see, it looks like some sort of diamond. And apart from medicinal use, a fiber is obtained from this plant, which is used in making of fishing nets and ropes. Now, another herb of family Malvaceae, that is Cyda acuta, and it is commonly called as wire weed. And it has a yellow color, beautiful small flower, and it flowers during rainy season only. Next, we have a very common plant of family Asteraceae, and it is commonly called as coat button, that is Tridex procumbens, and it flowers throughout the year. Okay, we can see this all the times, and it shows a capsulum inflorescence, as we can see. Now we have another prostrate growing herb, that is Indigofera linii. It is commonly called as a nine-leaved indigo because it has nine leaflets in its leaf, as we can count in the picture. And it is very common in tropical and subtropical region. Next is Dhatura inoxia of family Solanaceae. It is also very common, and we have seen this plant in particularly the flower in religious ceremonies, and it is poisonous and psychoactive. Now, this is a very beautiful climber that we have, Trichoxanthus cucumerina, and we can see the flower, and there is some thread-like outgrowths come out of the petals, which intensify its beauty. It's a very beautiful climber. Now, another very common roadside plant, that is Calatropis gigantea. It is commonly called as milkweed because of the presence of milky latex in it, and it also flowers throughout the year. As we can see in the picture, the flower has a disc-like structure, central disc-like structure. This is called as gynostasium. Now, we have a very small herb, that is Oxalis corniculata. The name Oxalis is due to the presence of oxalic acid in it. Next, we have another very beautiful climber, that is Pergularia damia, and the flower shows the presence of gynostasium as well. See, these are the disc-like structure, gynostasium, and it flowers during rainy season only. Another plant we have is Anisomelis indica, and it also belongs to mint family Lamiaceae, and this plant has a typical mint-like fragrance. Next is Physalis minima. It also belongs to family Solanaceae, and it is commonly called as Cape gooseberry. And the fruit is a fruit of Physalis shows persistent sepals, even after the fruiting is there, the sepals is remains. Further, we have a succulent, that is Cistus woodrowi, and it is rich in antioxidant, and it is used in herbal supplement usually. Now we have another very beautiful wild plant, that is Martinia annua, and it is commonly called as cat's claw. As we can see in the picture, the tip of the flower, it looks like a claw of a cat, and hence it is called as cat's claw. Next is Rangia, which is a very minute plant. The flower is so small that it is about 3 to 5 millimeter in length. So it is a very small and minute plant. Further, we have Justicia adathoda, and which we can see the bunch of flowers. Okay, the very beautiful flowers, and it is commonly called as Malabar nut, and it is native to Asia only. Now we have another climber called as Wattakaka volubilis, and it is a climber which climbs around a tree. As we can see in the picture, this is a tree. It is some different tree, and this is a climber which twines around it. Till now we have seen only herbs which are small and beautiful. Now we will look some trees of Seminary Hills which adds up in the beauty of our college campus. So the first is Deilonyx regia of family Fabaceae, and this is a tree. This is the tree Deilonyx regia, and these are the flowers of Caesalpinia. It is same as that of Deilonyx. Only the difference is the flower is a little bit small. The Caesalpinia flower is small. Deilonyx regia has a bigger flower, and it flowers in the month of June. That is in summer season only. After this, we have Mimoscops elenzi. It is commonly called as bullet wood, and it is used in dental care, particularly in bleeding gums and pyrrha. Now, after this, we have a very beautiful tree that is Bombex savia. The flower of Bombex is an example of polyadelphous condition in Malvaceae family. Now we have another beautiful tree that is Gliriceria sapium. The flower is pinkish in color, and it shows papilionaceous corolla, as we can see. And we usually saw these trees in gardens as ornamentals. After this, we have a very common tree that is Ziziphus. The fruit of this tree we all must have eaten. That is bay. It's a very delicious fruit. Now we have Moringa oleifera. The fruit of this plant is used in curry, that is drumstick, as we know, and it is also it also has a medicinal value, and it is available in the form of powder as a medicine in market as well nowadays. After this, we have a Peltophorum pterocarpum. That is it is having a yellow color, beautiful flowers, and we usually find these trees in gardens as ornamentals. Also, it is used as furniture making. Next, we have a very common and a useful tree, Terminalia cataba, commonly called as Indian almond. And as we all know, almond is a rich source of vitamin E and almond oil. Now we have a very common ornamental plant, that is Polyarthia longifolia. It is also called as false Ashok. So these trees in gardens and parks for ornamental purposes. After this, we have
commonly
called as hard milk.
Mushahid, your slide is not changing. Slideshow is not changing.
Which slide?
Terminalia. It's on Terminalia.
Okay.
Ashoka, it didn't show.
Now it is visible, ma'am.
Abhi nahi hai. No. It's still show. Yeah. Now it's okay, Mushahid. Polyalthea, you can continue with Polyalthea.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So this is Polyalthea longifolia. It is commonly called as false Ashok, and as I have told you, and it is used in gardens and as an ornamental. Next, we have Alstonia macrophylla, that is commonly called as hard milk wood, and it is common in roadside, and we find a milky latex from this plant. Next, we have Pongamia pinnata, and it is commonly called as Pongam oil tree, and it is famous for oil which is extracted from seeds, which has medicinal properties. After this, we have Pithocelobium delsi, and it is commonly called as cheese bilai. And this fruit
Mushahidi,
also
we must have eaten. Lagging. Mushahidi, your slide is again lagging. It's showing pongamia. Please see to your
this. Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. There is not visible, ma'am.
It's pongamia, beta. Abhi. Yes. Yes. Now it's okay, Mushahid. Continue, beta. Continue.
Sorry for the technical glitches.
No issue. You continue.
Okay. Fruit of this plant as we have already must have eaten in our childhood, that is cheese bilai, as I told you. Now we have Sterculia urens, commonly called as Indian ghost tree, and it is very common in central India, particularly the forest of Penj and Kahana. After this, we have a very common and a medicinally important tree, that is Azadi recta indica. It is commonly called as neem, and as we all know, it is used as a biopesticide, and it has been used in Ayurvedic medicine since ancient times. Further, we have a very beautiful tree, that is Butea monosperma. The flower is used to obtain a dye which is used in festival like Holi, and it flowers at that time only in the season of Holi, and it is known as flame of the forest because of its bright color flower. Then after this, we have Melia azada recta. And it is same as that of the neem, except the size of the leaflet is little bit broad of this Melia. Now further, we have a very commonly seen plant that particularly on Dasera called as Sonapatta, that is Bauhinia. And apart from this, it is also used in making curry as well. It is called as Kachnar in the local language. Now we have Acacia leucophyllum, commonly called as Barbark, and it is usually used in snake bites, bronchitis, vomiting as well. After this, we have Chloroxylon sweetania. It is commonly called as Ceylon satinwood, and apart from medicinal use, it is used in furniture making as well. Next, we have a very commonly known plant, that is Ficus bengalensis, and it's commonly called as ficus or fig. And we must have eaten this, and commonly called as banyan tree. And the ficus is an example of Hypanthodium inflorescence, which is a special type of inflorescence. After this, we have Hardwickia bionata. The wood of this plant is so hard that it is used by butchers for chopping the meat. It is one of the hardest wood. Further, we have Senna Simia of family Fabaceae, and it's commonly called as Casso tree. Nowadays, this tree is on flowering in roadside. You can usually see this. We have Tectona grandis. It is commonly called as teak or sagwan, and the Simli Hill is dominated by this tree, and it is widely used in furniture making, as we all know. Nowadays these are in flowering. Next is Aglanthus exalta, and it is commonly called as tree of heaven, and apart from the medicinal uses, it is also used for furniture making. Further, we have Delbergia lanceolaria, and it is commonly called as Dandus in local language, and it is used in blood related disorder and syphilis usually. After this, we have Phoenix sylvestris, and it is a monocot of family Ericaceae, and the fruits are edible, and it is similar to that of date, and the fruit is orangish red in color. Next, we have Gardenia. It is commonly called as Cape Jasmine, and it is important for gum or resin which is obtained from this plant. And another one we have a Limonia acidema, commonly called as wood apple, and in locally it is known as kabit, which is a very rich source of vitamin C and other medicines as well. After this, we have Tebebua rosea, commonly called as trumpet tree, and the decoction of this tree is used to reduce pain and inflammation. It is also used as ornamental for its red color flowers. After this, we have Bridalia retusa.
Musahid, your presentation is not moving better.
And which slide, ma'am? Tebebua?
It's still in gardenia, beta. Gardenia. हाँ अभी दिखा बेटा दिखा एक बार बता दो आप इसको फिर नेक्स्ट पे जाइए ठीक है
Limonia acidissima I told you it is known as kabit for rich in vitamin C the fruit and then Tebebua rosea it is also used as an ornamental in gardens After this, we have Bridalia retusa. It is commonly called as Pinus pheno tree, and it is used in hemiplegia and particularly urinary infections as well. Next, we have Pterocarpus marsupium. It is locally known as Vijayasagar. The speciality of this tree is you can see the fruit. These are fruit and it looks like leaves. Okay, it is a leaf like winged fruits. So after this, we have a very common tree that is Ficus religiosa, commonly called as peepal. And apart from its religious importance, it is also used in asthma, diabetes, and epilepsy. Of beautiful campus, which we studied as a part of botany project. And the plant is not complete. Many plants, many beautiful plants are yet to be explored. And this presentation would not have been filled out of the box thinking of Dr. Nikhat Naqvi ma'am to study the flora in its natural habitat. We feel blessed to be in this new environment in the lap of Mother Nature. And I, along with Sana, thank our principal, sir, Dr. K.T. Thomas, for providing full support in all our endeavors. Study without proper guidance is not possible. And I want to thank Botany Department of our college, especially Dr. Nikhat Naqvi ma'am, head of the Botany Department, for giving us guidance at every step of our field project. And thank you so much, ma'am, for believing in us and giving us this wonderful opportunity to present our work on online platform to large number of audiences at national level. And special thanks to Bhushan sir for his technical assistance. And it would not have been possible for us to give this presentation without his guidance. So thank you, sir, for training us in the technicalities of online platform. Thank you.
Thank you, Mushaid and Swana, for enriching our knowledge about the floral diversity and making us aware about the rich biodiversity of our own campus. Good afternoon, everyone. Flora. Flora is indeed vital part of ecosystem. And today, we learned that vital part of our own campus. We were instilled with so much of knowledge about the flora of our campus and its importance. This webinar has made us love our beautiful campus more than we already did. We students have been greatly motivated by our seniors. So, there are some questions came from our participants. Mushaid and Sana?
Yes.
Are you ready for the question and answer session?
Okay. Try,
My first question is for Sana. Why is acestacia named so?
Okay, so acestacia, it's the genus name and it means inconsistency. It belongs to the family Acanthaceae. So the members of Acanthaceae family are usually irregular. And so acestacia stands out with having a regular corolla. So that is why it's named so, based on the meaning that it is inconsistent.
Yes, thank you, Sana, for answering. Mushaid, my second question is for you. Why is Indian ghost tree, and what is Indian ghost tree, and why is it called so?
Okay, Sterculia urens is called as Indian ghost tree, and it belongs to family Malvaceae, and it is called so because the color of the bark. Okay, it has a white color bark, and in night it appears, you know, it gives a ghostly appearance, particularly at night, and hence called so.
And my last question to Mushaid, which books you have referred for this presentation, for preparing this presentation?
Okay, see, I have referred couple of sources, and the main source is The Flora of Nagpur Region by Sir Uge Muge. And I have referred some website also, for example, flowersofindia.com and .com, then invasive.org, a few websites I have referred for preparation of this presentation.
Okay, thank you Mushaid for answering. And there are many comments came from our participants for this webinar. That webinar was very interesting and informative for students, and very helpful for students also in studying. And it was a very nice collection of floral plants which you have shown in the presentation. And we are now at the conclusion part of our seminar. I, Saurabh Satpute, take immense pleasure to propose vote of thanks on this occasion on behalf of all the students of Botany Department. I would like to thank our principal, Dr. K.T. Thomas sir, for his endless encouragement and support of such webinar. I express my gratitude to our presenter, Mr. Mushaid Khan and Ms. Sana Shad, for their wonderful presentation on Floral Diversity of Seminary Hills, Nagpur. Mushaid and Sana, student of SFS College, have made us aware of the rich flora of SFS College campus in which we are studying, and has thrown light on every aspect of the topic and enhanced our knowledge about wild plants and trees of our campus. The presentation was very interesting and informative. Congratulations Mushaid and Sana for your wonderful presentation. I would like to thank Head of Botany Department, Dr. Nikhat Nakvi ma'am, for organizing this enriching webinar. My sincere gratitude to Dr. Nikhat ma'am for her constant hard work, help, support, encouragement, inspiration, guidance, and helping us to know the rich floral diversity of our college campus through the Free Project. Thank you, ma'am. Last but not the least, I would like to thank our organizing team of webinar, Bhushan sir, Surbhi ma'am, Roja sir, Ithika ma'am, Reshma ma'am, Pinky ma'am, for their technical and logistic support. I would like to thank our participants for joining us from far off places. Thank you everyone.